There is a language that the poor people say that can make them poor forever, even till old age. This language is what their subconscious mind grabs that make them to remain poor. You might be using the language, but you never know if it is the language of the poor. If you want to know if you are among the people who have used the language that make them to remain poor or average up till now, keep watching and let's dive into what the Bible says about wealth. Hello everyone, my name is Avalake Janet Oyelami. The Bible makes us to know, the Bible confirmed that he who has a slack hand become poor, but the hand of diligent make them rich. This can be seen in the book of Proverbs chapter 10 verse 4. God said, it is him who give you and me and everyone ability to become rich. He is the one who give us ability to produce wealth. But why are some Christians still have the mindset of poor and average, even when God said he is the one who give us the ability to produce wealth? But before I continue into today's topic, let me give the keyword that summarizes today's topic. The keyword for today says, language of the poor. What if this happens? What if I lose my money or brain? Stop your negative thinking. That is why the poor refuse to take action into success. Take the risks and stop saying what if this or that happened. The successful today took dangerous action that made them fail sometimes, but they kept going till they achieved their dreams. So, what exactly is the meaning of poverty mindset? Poverty mentality is a mindset that people develop over time based on a strong belief that they will never have enough money. This mindset is driven by fear and can cause poor financial decision making. Like I said earlier, why do some Christians or some people still remain poor or average, even when God says he's the one that give ability to produce wealth? Number one, they use the language of what if this or that happen? What if I fail? What if I lose my money? That is the number one language the poor or the average people say when they are meant to move forward or take an action into success. Maybe the reason why they keep on saying this kind of language is because maybe they have ventured into a particular business before and they failed, and this made them to make a decision that they will never venture into any business to take risks anymore. Thomas Edison, who made the electricity we are using today, failed 1,000 times before he finally produced the light you are using today. I heard the story of a CEO of Starbucks Coffee. They said he went to 317 people for help, for capital, to start the coffee business, but all of them rejected him. Why didn't he stop at 317 and say he gave up? But he kept on going forward until he found someone who helped him and partnered with him. You have to get to a point in life where you say you are desperate to achieve what you really desire. If it's wealth you desire, you must be desperate, be persistent, is what the Bible says, till you achieve it. Hear this shocking truth again, that when you keep on seeing all this setback, be happy, because it is a sign that your dream originates from God. So, be persistent until you win. Number two language of the poor that make them to remain poor or average is, what of if I lose my money? What of if I lose my brain? The successful people invest into what will bring success in the end. Even if they lose money at the beginning, they keep on researching until they achieve their dreams. What the successful focus on is the end result. That wealth, that success they are trying to achieve is what they focus on, not the money they lose. Because they know that the money they lose, they will get more than that when they achieve their success. James 1 verse 4 says, let your endurance have its perfect result, so that you may be perfect and complete, lacking nothing. So keep moving forward. So what is the solution to overcome this poverty mindset? Number one, desperately desire to make a positive confession every time. Negative is meant to come into our mind every time. Fear will come into our mind whenever we want to take any step. What you need to say, and we move forward. Create a confession that will give you boldness to keep moving forward. Proverbs 23:7 says, as you think, so you become. So when negative thoughts or fear comes, rebuke it, change your thinking to positive. Confess loudly, confess in your heart. That is how you win the battle. Number two, you have power to control your mind. So be in charge of your thinking. Number three, rewire your mindset. Maybe you have to change what you are watching. You have to change what you are listening to. What your ear hear, what your eyes see, that is what will go into your subconscious mind. And that is what will either make you to achieve your dream or not achieve it. Rewire your mindset through what you are watching, what you are listening to. Last but not the least, work hard on your dream. Research on how to achieve your dream. Look at other people's experience. Read their experience. Read their stories on how they achieve their dreams. Research more on how others achieve their dream. Learn from other people's experience and keep moving forward. When you do all this, your subconscious mind will finally agree with you that you are ready to move forward and achieve your dream. So if you want to achieve your dream or become wealthy, as God has promised every one of us, change your thinking, change your mindset, rewire your subconscious mind to follow your dream. God is the one that gives you ability to produce wealth. So believe in this. Hope this encourages you. Run after your dream. Speak to you soon. God bless.